Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today I'm going to show you how to perfectly center a window on your Mac using a script. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So some of the most popular system extensions for the Mac are programs that will allow you to position and organize the windows on your screen. But I like to do things without third-party apps whenever possible. And you can use scripting to position windows and do things like center them. As a matter of fact, centering a window is something I often want to do, and I've been asked recently by a few people how you can perfectly center a window on your screen. So here's a script that will do that. So for instance, here I have the Reminders app, and let's say I want this to be perfectly in the center. I can get it close by just moving it there. But let's say I want to use a keyboard shortcut and it just snaps right to the middle of the screen. So we're going to do this in Automator. In Automator, we're going to create a quick action. And then the quick action is just going to have one thing in it. And that's going to be run JavaScript. So right here where it says your script goes here, that's where we're going to start with our script. The first line is simply going to get the current application, so whatever app you're using, and the frontmost window of the list of windows, the one that's first, position 0. And we'll store that in the variable top window. Next, we'll get the boundaries for that window. So top window dot bounds. And we'll store that in window bounds. Now let's actually return that here, doing nothing else, just to test it out. So if I run and then I look at the results, I could see that this window is at position 159, X and Y position, and it's 997 wide, 610 high. It's referring to the frontmost window of the app we're using, so the Automator window itself. So next, let's get the size of the screen. We can do that looking at the application finder, the desktop, and the window of the desktop. So in other words, this background here is treated as a window, and we can get the bounds of that. In other words, the total size of this screen. And that will also be stored in a variable with an X, Y, width, and height. So now from that information, we can calculate the exact position to put the window. First thing we want to do is figure out the X position. To do that, we're going to take the width of the screen, we're going to subtract the width of the window. That gives us the remaining space to the left and right sides. We'll divide that by 2 because we want half of that to be on the left side of the window, half to be on the right. So if we set the X position of that window so it's exactly at this location, then the window in its current size will be centered horizontally. And now we'll do the same thing but with the vertical position. So we'll take the height of the desktop, subtract the height of the window, divide that by 2, and set the vertical position to that exact number. Now what we need to do is instead of returning a value, we don't need to return anything, we just need to set the boundaries of that window to our new value. So the width and height are the same. We've only changed the X and the Y value. So we reposition the window to be at a spot where it's exactly centered. Now let's try that here. If I run, it should act on this current window, the Automator window. So you can see it does. It centers this window. Now we want this to work as a service in any app. So we're going to have to make some changes here because we're getting the top window of the current application. But when we run this as a regular script in the services menu, this isn't going to work because the current application is technically the script that's running, not the window you're using. So we're going to have to replace this here to get the top window in another way. To do that, we're going to use this code here. So these three lines first are going to get the name of the frontmost app. So it's going to look at system events, all the processes running, and do a search, but only return the app where frontmost is true. And then it's going to get the name of that app. So the name of the frontmost app. Then it's going to go and say, great, the front app is that application with that name. And then we can get top window of the front app. So this will work even if we're not running this in Automator. But it should work in Automator as well. Matter of fact, if we move this window out of the way here, run, we can see it works just fine. Notice I've saved this file now and I've called it center window. So that's how it's going to appear in the services menu. We'll try using it here in Reminders. So we'll go to Reminders, Services, and then Center Window. Now, it's going to warn us about permissions. It's going to say that System Events wants to control this. We'll say OK. After we grant it permission, you can see it works. Now we don't need to do that again. So reminders here, we go to services, center window, it'll just do it. But it will ask for permission the next time we want to use it in a different app. So in the contacts app, we go to services, center window, and then we have to give permission again, and now it'll work in the contacts app from that point on. We can check those permissions by going to system preferences and then to security and privacy. Privacy, we'll see under automation the apps there. So they are system events for contacts and they are system events for reminders. So these are added there each time that we run it in a new app. So now all we need to do is assign this as a keyboard shortcut. So in system preferences again, we'll go to keyboard, we'll go to shortcuts, we'll go to app shortcuts, and then we'll add one here, and we need to set it to all applications. And the menu title is exactly what's seen under services here, center window. So we type center window. And we'll do a keyboard shortcut. I'm going to do control command and the backslash and add. So now let's move this here. If we go into reminder services, we actually see that keyboard shortcut there now. And I could just use it to quickly center the reminders window. Now there are tons of variations on this. For instance, let's say you want to center the window just horizontally but have it snapped to the top of the screen. Well, just set the Y value instead of to that, to 0. Now if I save and I use the keyboard shortcut, you could see it does exactly that. So I could have saved this as center top window and had a different keyboard shortcut for it. If I want to snap the window to the top right, then instead of dividing by 2, I would just use the full value of the extra space, so all the extra spaces on the left. So I'm going to save that and use the keyboard shortcut. You can see it snaps it to the top right. And let's say I wanted it to be just the right half of the screen snapped to the upper right hand corner but not changing the height. So what I could do is take the window bounds width and set that to the desktop bounds but divided by 2, which is the half of the width of the screen. And then the X value I could also set to there. So setting the width to half of the screen and the X value to half of the screen, that should actually put the left side of the window right in the middle and extending half of the screen. So I'll save that, use the keyboard shortcut, and you can see it puts it horizontally in the right half of the window. It doesn't do anything with the height. So there are tons of ways to customize these using the simple math here to get the window to go to any position you really want. Also keep in mind you can hard code values in here, and this is really useful if you have more than one screen. So if you have a second screen attached to your Mac, then the desktop bounds are going to be very different and it's going to be hard to figure out the center of the actual current screen. So you may want to actually set these to specific values. Like here I know that my main screen is 1280x720, so now I can run this and it will center perfectly regardless of whether or not I have extra screens attached to my Mac. So if you find that desktop bounds isn't useful because you have multiple screens, you can just use hard-coded numbers in here. That'll work just for you on your current setup.
I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.